दिस इज डॉक्टर विजयलक्ष्मी नायडू, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर बॉटनी, गवर्नमेंट VYT ऑटोनोमस PG कॉलेज दुर्ग, विथ टुडेज टॉपिक डिस्कवरी नॉमनक्लेचर एंड कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ एंजाइम्स. स्टूडेंट्स, दिस टॉपिक इज इन MSc बॉटनी सिलेबस of enzymology, and it is also in the BSc third year botany first paper second unit. Before starting this topic, students, I would like to tell you the exact definition of enzyme. Enzymes are defined as organic biocatalyst synthesized by living cells. And in this diagram, you can see that enzymes are substrate specific. So specific enzyme functions on specific substrate, and at the end of the reaction, the enzymes, they remain unchanged and the product is formed. Students, now we are having here the characteristics of enzymes. You can see here that are organic biocatalysts. They increase the rates of chemical reactions. They accelerate reaction rate by a factor up to 10 to the power 6 or more. Enzymes are not consumed or altered in the reactions they catalyze. Enzymes are highly powerful and they have the catalytic activity. They are highly specific in their action. Enzymes are thermolabile and colloidal in nature. Most of the enzymes are proteins in nature. Typical enzymes are globular proteins having the molecular weight 12,000 to over 1 million daltons. Students, if we see the discovery or the history of enzymes, enzymes were discovered in 1700 century, and when the study on starch converting into sugar was going on by saliva or by plant extracts, and when the study of meat digestion by secretions of gastric juices in stomach was taken place, at that time the enzymes were discovered. Then in 19th century, the Louis Pasteur concluded that fermentation of sugar into alcohol in the presence of yeast cells took place in the presence of some ferments, and in 1878 German physiologist F.W. Kuhne first used the term enzyme. In Greek, the term enzyme means in living. Then in 1926, James Sumner isolated the enzyme urease, and in 1930, the pepsin enzyme was crystallized. Students, till early 1980s, it was prevailed that all enzymes are proteins. Tom Sage and Sidney Altman were the scientists who first time shown the catalytic activity of RNAs, and these RNAs are ribozymes. RNAs play role in gene expression rather than metabolism, and as we all know that the site of these RNAs is in cytoplasm, on a cell organelle, etc. And in enzymatic reactions, substrates, the molecules at the beginning of the process, and products, the enzyme converts them into different molecules at the end. Means the enzyme works on substrates and converts them into products, and enzyme itself remain unchanged at the end of the reaction. If we go through the characteristics of enzymes, we can see here that almost all enzymes are proteins. Enzymes follow the physical and chemical reactions of proteins. Enzymes are heat labile. They are water soluble. They can be precipitated by protein precipitating reagents, and they contain 16% weight as nitrogen. Is specific in their action. We have discussed also earlier that a specific enzyme functions on a specific substrate, and the specificity is a characteristic property of the active sites of enzymes. And types of enzyme specificity are stereo specificity, reaction specificity, and substrate specificity. Now, the nomenclature of enzymes. The enzymes were named on the substrate they catalyzed without any definite guideline for nomenclature in the earlier. But to make these names more systematic and more informative, the International Union of Biochemistry constituted an enzyme commission in the year 1964, and it was recommended that there should be two nomenclatures for enzymes: one systematic and other trivial. The systematic name was given in accordance with definite rules, and trivial name was short but not very systematic. So, nomenclature or the naming of the enzyme is according to the reaction they carry out. The suffix "ase" is added to the name of the substrate. For example, lactase is the enzyme that cleaves lactose, or the type of reaction, for example, the DNA polymerase forms DNA polymers. Systematic names are based on International Union of Biochemistry and Molecular Biology and Enzyme Commission. International Union of Biochemistry and Molecular Biology classified the enzymes into 6 major classes, and these classes are oxidoreductase, transferase, hydrolase, lyase, isomerase, and ligase. Now we are going to see the very first class of the enzymes, and that oxidoreductase. These are the enzymes which catalyze oxidation reduction reactions. For example, the lactate dehydrogenase oxygenase oxidize the L-lactate into pyruvate. Enzyme is transferases, as the name is given to this class. Transferases means these enzymes, they catalyze group transfer reactions. One example we have taken here in the form of alanine transaminase enzyme, which transfers the amine group from L-alanine to alpha-ketoglutarate so that the L-glutamate is formed. Class of the enzyme is they catalyze hydrolysis reactions, where water is the acceptor of the transferred group. Examples are esterases, peptidases. One example is taken here in the form of pyrophosphatase enzyme. This enzyme is catalyzing here the hydrolysis of pyrophosphate into phosphate. The fourth group of or fourth class of enzyme is lyases. Lysis of a substrate, generating a double bond in non-hydrolytic, non-oxidative elimination. Example is pyruvate decarboxylase. Here it is catalyzing the lysis of pyruvate into acetaldehyde. Is they catalyze isomerization reactions. Alanine racemase is the enzyme which catalyzes the reaction, and from L-alanine, its isomer D-alanine is formed. The last class of the enzyme is in the ligases, which are also known as synthetases. They catalyze ligation or joining of two substrates, and for this they require chemical energy in the form of ATP. The acetyl coenzyme A in the presence of ATP forms the malonyl coenzyme A. So here this reaction is because of the presence of acetyl coenzyme A carboxylase enzyme. So these were the six classes of enzymes. Now we are moving towards the code numbers for the enzymes, and these code numbers of the enzymes were given according to the enzyme commission. Here, each enzyme is described by a sequence of four numbers preceded by EC. The first digit represents the class, classifies the enzyme based on its reaction. Second digit stands for the subclass, which indicates the type of group involved in the reaction. Third digit is the subclass or subgroup, indicates substrate on which group acts. And the fourth digit gives the number of the particular enzyme in the list indicates. It means serial number of individual enzyme. And this code number of the enzyme we are going to understand with this example. Suppose the example or the code number of the enzyme is EC11127. Students, as we discussed here, that each enzyme is described by a sequence of four numbers. Here also four numbers are 11127. First number is 1. It means this enzyme is belong to first class. So what was the first class we have studied earlier? That is oxidoreductase. Now second number is also 1. It means the enzyme belongs to first subclass. This enzyme works on first subclass, that means CHOH group. Third number is also 1. It means subclass and uses NAD as acceptor. It means the third 1 digit shows here that or indicates here it belongs to subclass and uses NAD as acceptor. And the fourth digit is here 27. It indicates that the enzyme is in the list of 27 number of subclass. So students, I think you understood very well here that the nomenclature of enzyme, apart from this we have also discussed the discovery and characteristics of enzymes. I hope you all understood very well today's topic. Thank you very much. Stay home, stay safe.